start to play the game in November to hopefully play deep into March. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Palestra, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, the Ivy League Digital Network. Dan Fricks once again alongside Katie Allen. And Katie, winding down the last three games, but coming to call tonight, the Dartmouth Big Green, a team not to be taken lightly.
Yeah, Dartmouth really causes some difficult matchups. They start four girls over 6 foot, which is going to be really tough. If Penn lets them hang around, they're going to fight until the end.
Definitely whoever wants to win this game is going to have to come out early and often, take control of this game from the onset, and hopefully keep that momentum going into the second half as we wind things out. Coming up now, a special presentation. We're going to turn things over to our public address announcer, Mr. Rich Kahn, with a presentation for our own, Sidney Stepanovich.
Thank you.
tonight's contest. And this is over to Carmen Carnegie. Carmen? Thanks a lot, Corbin. And Katie, like Corbin said, you know, after that loss to Cornell last weekend, team's definitely going to have to reestablish their focus. Again, take care of the matter of the game at hand, as we said before in the pregame. Dartmouth not a team to be taken lightly, as the head coach Mike McLaughlin already in the ear of the the other side, head coach Bell Kuklamas. I know I just mispronounced that. Forgive me. But no stranger to the Fletcher, one-time assistant coach here at the Fletcher. Always great to see Bell back here in University City. The referees for tonight's contest, Mr. Michael Henderson, Donald Kaminsky, and Kevin Rowland, handling the matters on the hardwood. The opening tip goes to the Dartmouth Big Green, wearing the road black with green and white. And going right to left on the screen, Penn in the home white. As we get things going, Amber Mixon with the ball. Lechowitz. Lincoln Rowland, starting to work the perimeter. Dartmouth can shoot the three from range. They're going to have to keep an eye out as the shot goes up. That guy tipped a little bit, but nobody left to pick up the change. Daisy Jordan picks up the first two of the contest, 2-0 in favor of the Big Green.
Yeah, and that's definitely something you're going to see all game is offensive rebounding by Dartmouth. They're so tall, and they really battle and get their way in there. Shot by Lauren Whitlatch.
Whitlatch, excellent right back with a three-pointer. Last time these two met, Lauren Whitlatch literally shot the lights out of the building up at Lead Arena. Had to play the last few moments in the dark. Broke the scoreboard. This is why we can't have nice things. But Dartmouth trying to work back the other way. And with an early one-point lead. Jordan down low. Will get fouled on the way as Lake and Rowland. Foul is on Anna Ross. Taking a look at it once again, you see the foul on the way back up. Anna Ross collects their first ball. 72% from the line this year. Cannot get the first to go.
Yeah, that was a really good pass by Jordan. It was a tough, there's four Penn players right there, and he stuck it right in.
From the foul line, Rowland makes this level at three. And as Casey Chambers will get things started, Anna Ross now back to Chambers. Anna Ross now top of the arc, 14, goes in right hand, gets a nice ball in for two. Anna Ross, since we had this 25 points at UNH, has scored in double digits 10 additional times this year, getting her first two of tonight. Now the defense getting ready to stand. As Zabo on the right wing passing up top for Mixon. Back to Zabo, left alone, right wing, puts it and drains it. A triple for the junior from Budapest 100. Zabo herself broke the 1,000-point mark this year. She hit a jumper at the 8:45 mark against Yale. Michelle Wilkady kicks outside. Anna Ross fires through a three, and it's good.
It's good to see Ross be aggressive, especially from three-point range early in the game, because that's when she really has a great game.
Anna Ross with five of the Quakers' 8 points, and putting on the pressure as Chambers and Whitlatch now trying to come back. Whitlatch covers Zabo. A lot of time off the shot clock now with 10. Mixon with the ball. Back and forth they go. Lechowitz fires. She drains a triple. This could be a game settled from outside the arc if we keep this up.
good shooting that for both teams so far.
4 3-pointers already to the board. Dartmouth has the lead 9-8. Chambers. Off the foot. So Penn will keep the ball. 13 on the shot clock. Looking for Michelle Wachetti in the low post. Lauren Whitlatch. Going over to the right wing. Trying for the inbound pass, but the right foot, Lechowitz spins it out, so Tracy Chambers will try again. Lucchetti turns, left hand, short. Rebound for Dartmouth. Here comes Amber Mixon. Penn's definitely going to have to take care of the glass as well, both ends, but more importantly on the offensive part of the court. As Rowland, he'll take a three, fires, bounces out, and Stepanovic will take the rebound. Here comes Casey Chambers flying up the floor. Stepanovic from just inside the arch, he'll take 2 points for himself.
That was a good job by Chambers to push it quick to the wing, and then she knew she had the Sydney trailing behind her.
When you look at the tail of the tape, both teams just about even for 3 points, starting at 33%, 10-32. So, like we said, this could get interesting real fast. Lechowitz with the ball. 10 on the shot clock, she goes to Mixon. Now, inside, right hand, no good. And back the other way, Casey Chambers. Stepanovic, once again, same shot as before. He's now got four all the evening. Davo races up the right wing. The pass back to Mixon. Ashley Russell set to come in for the red and blue. Pass all along back underneath. Laura Whitlatch gets back and gets a hand to it. So help can arrive. Lauren Whitlatch with some great work.
Yeah, that was a really nice play by Dartmouth, but great defense by Penn. She had that wide open for a second.
She had it, but again, Lauren Whitlatch really having a stellar sophomore campaign. Anna Ross, Whitlatch, left wing, fires too strong, and a foul off the rebound is going to be against Lake and Rowland. Both teams with one foul each. Lauren Whitlatch will come out for Russell. Jackie Falconer will come in for Lucchetti. Andy Norman coming in for Dartmouth. Stepanovic takes the inbound, now to Chambers. Chambers rolling in the lane, right-handed floater, doesn't get a friendly roll. The loose ball picked up by Zabo, up come the big green. Driving, right side down, low time for a pass, nothing there. Anna Ross has it. So quickly in transition, here come the Quakers. Ross on the left side, 4:40 left to go. Russell steps up, jumper, no good. Will collect her on rebound in the corner. Anna Ross with a fresh shot clock, Casey Chambers will set up the next play. Now Stepanovic, inside, tries for Falconer. That picked off. Lechowitz gives to Mixon, and up the floor comes Dartmouth once again. Andy Norman now to Mixon. They get the call from the bench. Mixon will come back almost to the circle and start things up with 13 on the shot clock. Norman. Lechowitz now against Chambers, trying baseline. Chambers closing down the lane. Jordan, pull up jumper high post. It is good for her 4 point of the night.
That was a tough shot. Right into Panovich's face, not easy to do.
Give credit where credit is due. Dartmouth within one, and now working in and around the middle part of the floor. Chambers, Russell, Stepanovic, Anna Ross, Ashley Russell left alone on the left wing. Can't make him pay. Falconer can't get the board. Dartmouth back up once again. Mixon.
Penn doing a nice job of stopping Dartmouth in transition. You can tell they want to go, but more white jerseys back there than blacks. That's definitely something that they've improved on this week.
The transition game, something you and I talked about a great deal, but a nice floating right hand from Kate Lechowitz makes it a 13-12 lead now for the big green. But we were talking about the transition game. That was one thing that really got Penn last weekend up in New York. He's getting caught off guard with the transition as Stepanovic makes another jumper. Back and forth, a 1 point lead is exchanged here in the early part of the first quarter. Amber Mixon right here in front of us. Zabo on top. Mixon once again the right wing, trying down low. Jordan, quickly they move. Norman fires from the left wing, too strong. Ashley Russell the rebound. Russell to Chambers. And then Chambers will race up the floor. 2:20 left to go. Pens on top by one. Long pass. Ashley Russell left wing up top. Chambers now back. Going for Stefanovic again. And the Ross puts up another triple.
Penn's doing a really nice job moving the ball in that zone. They haven't been played in a zone very much this year, so it's interesting to see how they respond. Obviously, at practice, they practice it every day, so they should be used to it, but sometimes it's not as easy.
It translates out to game day.
Yeah. And it's a little different than they're seeing. It's more of like a 1-2-2, maybe. But
Jordan, turnaround jumper, getting past the Pavlovich for two more. She also has 6 points. 17-15 the score with 1:33 left. Russell. Anna Ross whipping the ball around. Chambers. Stefanovic. Floater. No good. Lekowitz the rebound. Dartmouth back up the floor. Back and forth they go. Mixon starting to settle things a little bit. Norman down the left side. A foul is called against Anna Ross. That's her second and the team's second. That brings us to a timeout on the floor. Back and forth action they go. Pens on top, 17-15. You're watching Penn Women's Basketball here on the Ivy League. Here's the
All right, listen up. Out on that field today, you will be ready for anything. And I want you to always remember, this is the greatest team you will ever be part of. There's important work to be done.
If I want
to, only some able to do it. Can you make the cut?
And a first shot attempt, it's up and over. She chips it in.
Per game as we get set to get back underway here at the Flush after the foul called against Anna Ross. Dartmouth getting an in jumper left side, drains in a triple from Kate Lickley. That's her second triple. Dartmouth now up 18-17. Ashley Russell inside for Stefanovic, the double coming. Chambers, she'll fire for a three, and it's good. Long range warfare in effect so far as pressure comes up from Penn. Norman. Now Mixon inside, down low, all left alone. Couldn't get it to go. Stefanovic with the defensive board. Nice work there by Dartmouth. Andy Norman seeing the opportunity to go low. Just could not capitalize. But Penn has the ball. Shot clock's unplugged. 13 left to go here in the first. Chambers. Three seconds. come back for a little bit more, but taking a look at some of the replays before we head out. Simmons to Patterson starting things off with 6 points. Hands down a 2-point lead. On the other side, Dartmouth doing their part as well. Back and forth it's going to be. Come back and find out more. You're watching Penguins basketball here at the Ivy League Digital Network.
With the card most accepted by top doctors and specialists, you have the compassion and security of Blue Cross, giving you the strength to drive forward. Independence Blue Cross. Live fearless.
Who's ready to ski and snowboard? Jack Frost Big Boulder Ski Areas has it all, plus more. Winter is here, and JFBB has exciting events and activities, plus skiing and riding conditions that are out of this world. Start the new year with savings. Visit JFBB.com and save up to 30%. Get information on the latest conditions. Check out the calendar of events. See live webcams. And sign up for weekly email blasts. Jack Frost Big Boulder, where the snow comes first.
Brown, Columbia, Cornell, Dartmouth, Harvard, Penn, Princeton, and Yale. Synonymous with academic and athletic excellence, the Ivies have the broadest intercollegiate programs in the country. That means more teams, sports, and student athletes than any other intercollegiate athletic conference. These men and women combine national competitive success with the best academic records in the NCAA. Experience the Ivy League yourself at IvyLeagueSports.com.
Especially for you, Katie, as well. Just this time last year, celebrating your 4 years of Penn basketball. As right now, Simmons to Patterson, the jumper can't get it. Casey Chambers racing in for the rebound. Thought Whitlatch was up top, but Zabo picks it up. Up the floor now, come the big green. Kick out, three-pointer on the way. Lechwitz is called for the travel. That fast, going back and forth. Katie, we talked about the three-pointers. 13 three-point shots were put up between both teams in that first 10 minutes. As here comes another one. Lauren Whitlatch from the right side. It's good for three more.
Yeah, both teams shooting over 50% from the field. And in that first quarter, we'll see, you know, which team can keep it up. If this is going to be like that, or is it going to turn into a defensive battle in a little bit?
9-10 left to go here in the second. Lauren Whitlatch opening things up with the triple. Dartmouth trying to return the favor in kind, cannot. And Michelle Lachetti with the rebound. Chambers. She'll take it herself. Jumper just inside the arc. No good. Lachetti to put back. Can't get it to roll. Another time to come, but it still can't fall. But still goes to the line. 4-2. Lincoln Rowland gets called for her second. Team's first of this quarter. That puts Lachetti on 4-2. Taking a look at it again, Michelle doing the work down low, but gets fouled on the way up for the last attempt. Just can't get a friendly roll from the guys. Sent on the line on this season.
Yeah, and that definitely hurts Dartmouth with Lake and Rowan having two fouls already. Even if she's not scoring, she's just a huge presence out there and causes so much attention that makes other people open on the floor.
Ashley Russell comes off. Anna Ross back in. Lauren Whitlatch, Lachetti, Chambers, and Stepanovic on the floor right now for the red and blue. Lachetti can't complete the two from the line. Dartmouth back up the other way. 24-18 favoring the Quakers. Zabo. Lechowitz. Now mixing towards the left elbow with 15. Comes up top. Climbing inside. Olivia Smith in the ballgame. Smith kicks out with 8. Lechowitz now trying again. Smith up against Lachetti. Nothing there. And a combination of Stepanovic and Ross in the rebound. Long pass, left side. On the way. Three-pointer left again. This time from Casey Chambers. 8:12 left to go. Dartmouth will call timeout. And that brings us up to a timeout on the floor. 27-18 is the score here at the Palestra. You're watching Penn Women's Basketball here on the Ivy League.
Before I worked with Kanye West, before I performed with Stevie Wonder, way, way before my solo album and the Grammy for Best New Artist, before all of that, this was my studio. Today, my greatest influences are my family, soul music, and the University of Pennsylvania.
With a name trusted for nearly 80 years, you have the compassion and security of Blue Cross, giving you the courage to enjoy the ride. Independence Blue Cross. Live fearless.
Welcome back to the Palestra. The little ones, as always, great to have them supporting Penguins basketball. Both of them coming up at the half. And take a look around at the Ivy League action. Important games going on, especially up the turnpike. Also take a look at a special halftime presentation. You'll want to stick around for that. A game that only happens once a year. You'll see it more at halftime. Right now, 27-18 is the score here in Philadelphia. 8:12 left to go as we come out of the timeout. Katie, we're looking at some of the stats. Penn taking care of the rebounds. 12-7 right now. Favor of the Quakers, 6 of 9 from 3. That being the difference so far. Again, the score 27-18 as Dartmouth will inbound the ball. Working from right to left on your screen. And bringing the pressure as well as Amber Mixon goes to her left and gets down to Ross. Ross will drop back. Mixon goes to her right. Working inside, kick, right side, Zaba, down low, almost lost it with Mixon. The 12 on the shot clock, Mixon comes to the right, Lefkowitz. Mixon, once again, trying to press to the left end. Long range three, put up heavy off the iron, can't get it, Dartmouth with the rebound.
I think the fan had a little influence on that one. They start counting down so early, and sometimes they fool the players.
Amber Mixon with the ball, now trying to go left side, Lefkowitz keeps it in, Mixon once again. With 15 on the shot clock. Lefkowitz, Mixon exchanging passes. Trying to go down low, but right back to Mixon. 6 on the shot clock. Mixon now trying to roll. 2. The shot up, it'll count, but off the rim into the hands of Sidney Stepanovic. Anna Ross comes up to the right side. Casey Chambers. Andy Norman set to come in for Dartmouth. As Anna Ross looks right side, Chambers once again. Stepanovic going low. Locchetti high off the glass. It's good for three. Stepanovic with the assist. Locchetti with her third point. 29-18. Favor of the Quakers.
That was a good job by Penn. Getting it inside against the zone, too. They're not just showing that they're going to make threes and score outside. Might be able to get Dartmouth out of this zone.
Lefkowitz firing it from pretty much the Schuylkill River, but unfortunately not connecting. Anna Rosta racing up the right side. She goes into the right wing, passing inside Stepanovic. Now left side, Chambers once again fires, can't get it to go. Stepanovic to put back, it's 52-more. 31-18 now, Penn opening things up here in the second. Amber Mixon comes across the line, comes to the middle of the floor. 20 on the shot clock. She'll give to Zaba. Mixon once again the right wing. Trying to inch their way inside. Zaba now with it. In traffic. Now baseline with 3 seconds going up. Can't get it to go. Loose ball. Anna Ross comes in and protects it. As Lauren Whitlatch picks herself up from the floor. And back the other way. Ashley Russell set to come in for the Quakers. On the left wing. Casey Chambers comes back to the split P logo on the floor. New play gets called in with 10 seconds. Has the ball again. Inside, Stepanovich. Right side, Whitlatch. With five. Anna Ross on the left wing. Ross. Going to go. Up top. Not going to get it off. Nope. Shot clock violation. Unfortunately, Payne could not get it away. The bench not happy. When you see Mike McLaughlin and Chris Day on your screen. Lauren Whitlatch will have a seat. Ashley Russell back into the ballgame.
Yeah, that's always something that Coach McLaughlin gets very frustrated about, is shot clock. He always says shot clock awareness in practice and games. Something that frustrates him the most.
Darvis now with the ball, 14 on the shot clock, long to the left side, Lekowitz. She gets, well, Kenny the bite. High bounce off the rim, won't fall. Penn with the rebound. Jason Chambers, once again, head coach Mike McLaughlin playing the role of traffic cop. You can laugh at it a little more when you're on this side.
Yeah, I can. I mean, I never had to be the one, though, to bring the ball up, so didn't have to necessarily deal with it.
The battle of its turnaround jumper, right high throws is short. Easy rebound for Lekowitz. Dartmouth trying to work their way back up the floor. Side, Smith. Smith, turnaround jumper. That also no good. Marchetti comes in for the rebound. Penn is going to call a timeout. 3:54 left to go here in this second quarter, and Penn's defense has held Dartmouth off the board for this second quarter, an 0-8 run for the red and blue. And that was one thing that you and I were talking about as before we went on the air. Is the momentum going into the locker room? Who has the lead and how much was it? Right now, Penn taking care of that 31-18.
Yeah, it's really important for Penn to finish this half out strong, because if they let Dartmouth back into the game.
Thanks, Dan. If you want to join the conversation, use the hashtag ILBN fight on Penn as well. Get your tweets of the game in. You may see them on the screen later on. And that young lady undoubtedly tweeting about this performance. But judging by the color of the shirt she's wearing, it is unclear who she may be supporting. So we'll have to see later on. Dartmouth 0 for 8 this quarter, in addition to not having any points on the board. So give credit for Penn's defense as well. As Michelle Rossetti tries to drive, right hand floater, no good. I think Jordan got a piece of it. Fanny Zabel coming up the floor to the right. Lauren Whitlatch has to come in for the Quakers. Norman. Jordan. Jordan driving against Stepanovich. Can't get it to roll. And Rossetti with another rebound.
That's how this half has been going for Dartmouth. As much as Penn has played good defense, Dartmouth has just had a few of those of just barely rolled in. Yeah. The first half, you got so many of them, but
inside, Rossetti all alone off the glass. That's a roll for two more points. Making it 33-18. Norman coming up the floor. Lekowitz. Now Fanny Zavo will call on the play right at the circle with 20 to shoot. Lekowitz with 12. Zabo, left wing, fires a three off the glass, can't to go, but the putback, and Andy Norman gets the first points for the Big Green in this quarter. It's 33-20. Michelle Wachetti now gives to Panovich, jumper, right side, off the iron. Ashley Russell got a hand to it, comes away with it. Almost threw that towards us. Casey Chambers. With a good left hand, kept it in play. Penn with a fresh shot clock. Now Rossetti. Rossetti's going to drive, but a foul is called on the way. And it's going to be against Daisy Jordan. Team's second of the quarter, Jordan's first. as Lauren Whitlatch will come back in. Ashley Russell will come out. Chambers against Zabo. Calls on the play. Now to her left, Lauren Whitlatch. Stepanovic, right high pose. Heavy off the iron, heavy off the top of the backboard, and goes over, so out of bounds. 1:50 left to go, and Dartmouth will have the ball. Penn still putting up the pressure. Zabo. Looking to go left, he's got Norman, takes that pass. Lechowitz up top with Penn. Now trying to work inside. Jordan underneath. Rattles in two more points. For Jordan, that's 8 points on the evening. Penn's lead is now 11.
Yeah, Dartmouth is starting to pass it around a little bit better in that zone. As much as Nixon does a nice job of running their offense, she's not as much of an outside shooter. So having three shooters definitely helps. As Anna Ross drives in, gets a nice layup.
Anna Ross for two more. Fanny Zabo comes up. Penn's defense settling back in. Chambers giving pressure, but down low. Zabo left all alone. Finds the back door, knocks down her fifth of the evening. As we are under 35 seconds left to go here in the first half. Michelle Wachetti. Whitlatch, now Stepanovic. Anna Ross, left wing. That gets stolen off the right hand of Lechowitz. So the shot clock unplugged. Dartmouth is trying to go into the break with at least some momentum as they are down by 11. Zabo. Under 5 seconds. Jordan, jumper off the glass. Nothing. Put back for Norman is good. And horn sound for the break. Penn goes into the locker room up by 9, 35-26. And a stellar defensive stand by the Red and Blue, holding Dartmouth to no point within an 8.5-minute time frame. They go into the break with the lead. When we come back, highlights, recap, special halftime presentation. Make sure you check it out. You're watching Penn Women's Basketball here on the Ivy League Digital Network.
Definitely being invisible.
I would like to control people's minds.
To read people's minds.
Elasticity so I could dunk from half court.
And visibility.
Definitely invisibility.
Super speed.
To read people's minds. You know, I gotta think, see what they're thinking about me and stuff.
Ultimate protection from the sun so that I never get sunburn ever again a day in my life.
The smiley face with the sunglasses on.
The one that's like really wide smile.
The one that's like
bashful monkey.
This emoji.
This one.
Like, you know, like
this one.
The smirk, for sure.
The roll in the eyes emoji or the sweating one, because you know, that's like.
These are the Ivy League top plays of the week. We go up to Ithaca for the Ivy League Octagonal Indoor Track and Field Championships, a clinic from the Harvard women's 4x400 relay team. They helped capture the Crimson's fourth straight team title. And in addition to the 4x400 win, Gabby Thomas and Autumn Franklin rack up 5 individual titles for Harvard. Number 4, a big win for the Cornell women's basketball team. Nicole Aston with this elbow jumper under a minute left in the game with the shot clock winding down. Cornell hands Penn its first league loss of the season. Number 3, a top 10 showdown in lacrosse ends with a big statement from the Yale men's squad. This Michael Bonacci goal gave the Bulldogs the second half momentum on their way to an 8-5 win over 4th-ranked Maryland. Bulldogs are one of 3 Ivies in the top 12 national rankings. Number two, a pivotal moment in the 14-game tournament on the men's side. Yale is down 2 to Dartmouth until Makai Mason comes off a screen and nails that jumper with 5 seconds left. Bulldogs take the game in overtime and remain tied atop the league standings. And number one, final event of the weekend, and the Princeton 400-yard relay team clinches the team title in dramatic fashion. It's the second straight season that the Tigers have captured the team title. And that's it for this week's Top Plays. Stay engaged with the Ivy League on social media and watch all live and on-demand content at ildn.tv.
Card most accepted by top doctors and specialists, you have the compassion and security of Blue Cross, giving you the strength to drive forward. Independence Blue Cross. Live fearless.
Started as we were getting ready to come back and seeing some of the talent out there, maybe some passing that might have to work on a little bit. But welcome back to Philadelphia Denver's Katie Allen here at halftime score 35-26. And Katie, you know, a little bit anxious as far as this is coming down the final stretches of this season, and just needing to take care of the matters at hand in front of them, worrying about tomorrow night at that time. But so far, good effort put in by the Red and Blue.
Yeah, their Penn is shooting really well. They definitely have good ball movement in Dartmouth's zone, and they're playing really good defense, especially at the beginning of that second quarter.
But now for the next installment, Katie's Corner, and a little bit of an emotional weekend, I mean, especially for you, just a year ago yourself, going into your senior night weekend. What's it like for Pierre Jordan, getting into things as far as the weekend, and, I mean, tomorrow night, that could be it. I mean, that's how do you put that in the words?
It's really hard. You know, they had that little special video I saw on Facebook, I think, and they just talked about how much it meant to play in the Celestial. It's such a special place, and to be here for your last time is pretty emotional. And you just can't. You're surrounded by all your family members. It's just a great feeling. Also a sad one, too.
To be around your family as well as the Penn family and how strong it has really become within the past few years as well, taking a great program and putting it to the height as a deep three ball that's put up by a member of the Penn Band. I think he's been following Kate Lakewood's scout from Dartmouth earlier. So, but back to this weekend, we'll have more tomorrow night as we get into things, especially with the parents. We'll be talking with the Rays and the Jay family as well. But we got a little injury timeout here on the floor between the cheerleaders and the band. Both of them have a second half to play. That's take a look at the Ivy League standings. As we said, Princeton's here of matters at hand. Penn, Princeton sitting atop 10-1. Princeton hosting Harvard. Dartmouth at the 7-5 going into tonight's game. For Penn, well, you get a better look at what may come on Tuesday. Again, you must take care of what is going on tonight. As we'll check in on Princeton and Harvard later on, and Princeton as well take care of the matter at hand. For Harvard, if they can pull off an upset and come in here and pull off another upset, that could make things very interesting. We'll worry more about that later on tonight and into tomorrow. Halftime score 35-26 here at the Palestra. When we come back, highlights, recap, and analysis. Be sure you come back with us. You're watching Penn Women's Basketball here on the Ivy League.
I'm mean, it's mixed emotions. I'm excited for the weekend, ready to hopefully get another sweep. It's a really important weekend for us, but it's also sad that it's the last time playing in the Palestra.
There's nothing else better than the Palestra. Everybody wants to be in the Palestra, and I think that we take it for granted every day. And there's a lot of people who want to at least get the chance to play in the Palestra.
I don't think you really realize how special the Palestra is until your junior and senior year, and just now looking back and seeing everything that the Palestra holds and the specialness of it, it's definitely bittersweet.
The best part, I think it would be just laying on the beach. We'd practice in the morning and do our walkthroughs before games, and then we'd have some free time in the afternoon, and I think it was just a lot of fun just laying on the beach. The coaches would pass around the football, and Beth and Jackie would do it with them. It was a great time, just enjoying the good weather too.
I mean, obviously we went there for basketball reasons, but we had a whole experience. It wasn't just basketball experience and basketball focus. We got to do so many things, and it was just an incredible opportunity.
We knew we had to go out there and obviously compete, because there were two really good teams, and being able to have our free time too outside of basketball was really fun.
And we had a great crew. Everyone was a joy to be around. We had the athletic director, and some of her family was there. Alana was there with her husband. John D. Paola was there, and it was great to have everyone supporting us.
It was just a good experience for bonding even more than we already have. And, you know, we see the same girls, same 14 girls, every single day. We're naturally just going to become close, and which we did.
Welcome back to University City. Again, the score 35-26 at the half. Dan Fritz, Katie Allen for the Ivy League Digital Network. And first half back and forth, but then things opened up in the second quarter as Penn would stifle the Dartmouth Big Green for over 8 minutes without putting a point on the board early part of the second quarter, as we get ready to take a look at some of the highlights that occurred from that first half, brought to you by Academy Bus Lines. And Katie, as we said before, things got off early and quick. And before that, some great passing by the Penn band.
Great
top ball. Here's a deep three ball we were talking about. Off the glass. Counted. The cheerleaders returning to the field. In kind. A little contact on the floor as well. So the annual Penn band, Penn cheerleaders contest with the highlights as we get ready for a little post-game reaction from the Penn band. As we now send things over, Corbin Carnegie.
And guys, how does it feel to be out on the Palestra floor as a basketball player?
Oh, it's pretty amazing because the people who play here are fantastic, but I think that we've put up a pretty good fight and we're equally as good as the actual players on the basketball team.
As a member of the Penn band, you came out victorious today. How do you think your team performed?
You know, I feel very well. We had a great practice yesterday. We worked hard and we worked
hard. Thanks a lot, Corbin. It's great to have the support of the Penn band, the Penn cheerleaders. Again, Katie, you saw from your and yours here at Penn as well. There is nothing like them, is there? We're going to take a step aside real quick. When we come back, highlights and reactions from the first half of the Dartmouth Penn women's basketball game here on the Ivy League Digital Network.
Ivy League fans want Ivy League gear, and your home for Ivy League merchandise is at ivyleaguesports.com. With hundreds of Ivy League items, including jerseys, t-shirts, hats, and more, the online shop at ivyleaguesports.com has the greatest selection you'll find anywhere. You'll also get great customer service, 365-day hassle-free returns, and flat rate shipping on every order. So when you need Ivy League gear, head to the online shop at ivyleaguesports.com. The Ivy League Digital Network is your go-to digital destination for exclusive access to live events and on-demand content from around the league. Watch over 1,000 events from all 8 schools on one network, available across multiple devices including PC, mobile, and tablets. Plus, you can watch up to 4 games at once with QuadView and interact with other subscribers through the network's social media integration. The Ivy League Digital Network is your pass to catch all the action from around the league anytime, anywhere.
Welcome back to the Palestra. Halftime winding down. Just a few minutes left to go before we start the second half. And now taking a look at the highlights from our first half of action. Once again, brought to you by Academy Bus Lines. A game that got off to a fast pace, to a long-range pace early in this contest. As you see, the red and blue getting things set to go. Dartmouth Big Green would love to play the role of spoiler for the Quakers coming into tonight's game. But both teams will get things going early and often. Lauren Whitlatch, as she's done all year long here in her sophomore campaign, bringing the threes from the right side. Spinning Stepanovic finding her range at the top of the key, but Dartmouth not to be denied. Clever work just outside the paint, working down low as well. Getting the look off the glass, a couple of key offensive rebounds, but then going into the second half, it would be all as they get the work off the glass. Try to keep an eye for the halftime score as well, folks. Sorry about that. Michelle Wachetti doing her thing underneath the glass. The highlights brought to you by Academy Bus Lines. And taking a look at the score at the half of the turnpike. Real quick, Princeton is on top 36-30. Some of the numbers for this game as well. The field goal percentage, 48% by the red and blue, 60%, 6 of 10 from outside. Both teams, 1 of 2 from the line. The rebounds, as is the key part, and the turnovers as well. But hand on that side, giving up the ball just a couple of more times. As we get set for the horn to sound for the start of the second half, Katie, what do you see as far as what Penn needs to do to keep the momentum going here in the second half?
I think they really need to work the ball around, especially establish more of an inside presence right away. Who knows if those threes are going to keep falling. Obviously, keep shooting them, but definitely look to get the ball inside, maybe draw a few fouls, keep attacking.
For my end, make sure that you take care of things low into the baseline. For my comfort, I mean, Dartmouth was able to get around the defense just a few too many times and get those looks underneath. Fortunately for Penn, some of those shots did not go in. But if you keep giving them that opportunity, Dartmouth will find the mark and just start knocking the points down, taking care of this deficit. Right now, 35-26 is the score going into the third quarter. Dartmouth with the ball now working left to right on your screen. Penn right to left as we continue playing basketball here in the Cathedral of College Basketball. Starting with the ball right side, rolling. It's called for the travel, tried to pull up. The foot dragged, the whistle blown. Penn will have the ball. Casey Chambers will bring the ball up for the red and blue. Michelle Wachetti up top. Lauren Whitlatch. Anna Ross in the left wing comes inside for Wachetti. She puts to the floor the left hand, the glide, 2 more points for the sophomore from Missouri City, Texas. I always like when Michelle just has that nice glide, just lets it roll off the left hand.
Yep. Yeah, that was really good. Avoided the double team coming middle.
Dartmouth, though, now trying to answer back. Jordan has the ball. Jumper up right side, off the right hand of Roland is good for just her 4th point of the evening. Chambers through the midcourt goes to the right side. Lauren Whitlatch. Chambers once again. 13 on the shot clock. Whitlatch, she'll fire for 3, and it's good. Lauren Whitlatch, the hat trick of triples on the evening, making it 40-28. Nixon sends the ball to the left side, Lakewood. Down low, Jordan, baseline, right hand, off the glass. Pretty basket for Daisy Jordan.
There's that baseline you were talking about earlier. They have been doing a really good job of getting down there and getting below that back line of 10.
Daisy Jordan, her 10th point on the night, making this a 10-point affair. 40-30 is the score. Stepanovich with the ball, going down low. Wachetti up, couldn't get it to go over. A missed opportunity for the red and blue. Here comes the big green. Szabo to Mixon on the left side. Now up top, Roland. Getting Lekowitz over to the right wing. Mixon all in the corner. Roland dropping down. She'll pull up jumper. Too strong. Stepanovich the rebound. Anna Ross. She'll curl off. Give to Chambers on the left side. Now Whitlash. Stepanovich down low. Jumper right side. That one too heavy off the iron. A rare miss from that spot for Stepanovich. That's usually right within her wheelhouse.
Yeah, no one was on her. I think she's almost surprised how open she was. Dartmouth didn't match up quite well in transition.
Lekowitz, left side. A block by Michelle Wachetti. She brings the ball up and will give to Casey Chambers. So Wachetti with a great right hand. As Chambers, he'll glide a right hand, light off the front of the iron. Now the transition game coming into play. Here comes Zaba. Mixon. Now to Lekowitz, exchanging passes, 15 on the shot clock. Roland, inside the lane, right hand off of Lekowitz, no good. Stepanovich to board. Chambers. Ashley Russell set to come in for Ben. Anna Ross. Stepanovich. Chambers the right wing with 17. Left wing now. Whitlodge. Dartmouth's defense doing a good job. Here comes Lachetti. Left hand glide. Up, off. Can't get it to go. The putback foul should go to the line. Lincoln Rowland, the three fouls on the evening as Michelle Wachetti, once again, doing work underneath the basket, draws the foul. She'll shoot two. Split the difference on a first offering to four. Taking a look at it again. Wachetti just getting a look back. And Princess Aguirre checking into the ball game now for the Quakers. As you see Michelle Wachetti on your screen. Wachetti during the trip to New York. Total of 20 points, 15 rebounds in both games. Knocks down 3 of 4 from the line tonight. Changing things up again. Ashley Russell in the ballgame. Princess Aguirre, as we made mention. Two of the freshmen on the floor right now for head coach Mike McLaughlin. Szabo with 12, goes right side, Mixon. Mixon's going to go baseline, but a foul is going to get called against Lauren Whitlatch. First foul of the quarter for the red and blue, as well as for Lauren. Off the inbound, Jordan down low. Once again, a block by Michelle Wachetti.
Jordan tried to do everything she could. Nice shot fake there, but
Wachetti did a
nice
job.
Nice job of staying straight up.
Szabo, inbound, back to Jordan. Now to kick back up top, Mixon. Mixon once again to the corner. Lekowitz. Baseline, nothing there as that gets shut down. Trying inside. Ashley Russell a hand to it. And here comes Lauren Whitlatch. Anna Ross now with the ball. Ross, no shot. A foul against Dartmouth. That will be against Fanny Szabo. Team's second of the third quarter as Casey Chambers will come in for Anna Ross. So they'll mix things up a little bit. Ashley Russell will inbound as you see Ross heading to the bench. Chambers now on the left wing. It's good for three. Laura Whitlatch once again. The Penn bench, the reaction. They're up 45-30 with 5 minutes left to go here in the third quarter. Down low, turnaround right hand, no good. Aguirre might have gotten a piece of it. Here comes Chambers. Chambers, floater, right hand off the glass. A nice 3 point for the junior from Belmar, New Jersey.
That was a great move. That's something you're taught when you're younger, like that hesitation. That not many people use that, but she's definitely made the defense stand up there.
I wonder who taught her that. Probably mom.
Probably mom.
Dartmouth now trying to work right side. Jordan, baseline against Aguirre. Off the glass. Good work there by Princess Aguirre to get it to go. It goes out of bounds. Lauren Whitlatch thought it was going to be off of Dartmouth, but it was off of Penn. A timeout on the floor. 4:14 left to go here in the third. Penn is on top, 47-30. Casey Chambers, Lauren Whitlatch dropping the bombs from outside. Penn's on top. You're watching Penn Women's Basketball here. The Ivy League Digital Network. Great to see the fans giving their support here at the Palestra. Getting set to get back underway as Penn on top, 47-30. Dartmouth getting the inbound with 4:14 left to go. Mixon with the ball, going to the right side, Lechowitz. Mixon once again, head fake, but nothing there. Now trying to go inside, Smith trying to get down low once again. This time, Dartmouth sends it out of bounds. It'll be Penn ball back the other way. Dartmouth going to the bench as Andy Norman will come in. Amber Mixon will have his feet. Norman, 4 points on the evening. Total of 68 on the year. And season high, 7 points at Harvard earlier this season. Coming back in off the bench for the big ring right now. Penn with 20 seconds on the shot clock. Gives the chamber inside Marchetti. Marchetti baseline right hand up and underneath it.
That was a really good move by Marchetti. And again, nice to see her mixing up some moves in there. She always has her good drop step, her good spin back, but always nice to see players improving on something during the season.
Dartmouth now up top. Zabo going down low. The right hand returning the favor in time is Olivia Smith with her 111th point of the season.
If Dartmouth's new lineup will be better for that zone.
Chambers, she'll fire the right hand, no good. And Wilkenny is going to get called for the foul, going for the rebound. 2 seconds, Michelle's first. So only the fourth foul this game for the Quakers. Dartmouth as well, only had five.
Tends to be a common theme. to the Penguins. Not too many fouls.
And a tip to it. Michelle Wachetti. Here comes Casey Chambers. So a steal for the red and blue. The ball with 2:45. Chambers gives to Wachetti. Wachetti puts to the floor. It goes right hand. Line drive. Prince Bagheri went up to go for it. Just couldn't get up high enough. Dartmouth in quick transition. Now Lekowicz, she's going to go baseline up underneath. And this game's starting to get played underneath the glass. Lekowicz with a nice look under as well as Sydney Stepanovich set to come back in for the Quakers. And Casey Chambers comes over to the bench. And Ben calls timeout. 49-34 left to go here in the third. And that brings us to a timeout on the floor as well. 2:21 left to go here at the Palestra. 49-34 to score. You're watching Penn Women's Basketball here on the Ivy League Digital Network.
With the name trusted for nearly 80 years, you have the compassion and security of Blue Cross, giving you the courage to enjoy the ride. Independence Blue Cross. Live fearless.
Goes to the 20 with the left hand. Another bucket for the the mark tonight, making the score 53-34. And Casey really putting some pressure onto Kate Lekowitz as they come across the line. Andy Norman inside. Smith. Smith jumper inside the lane. Anna Ross the ball. 10 seconds left to go here in the quarter. 53-36 to score. Brooklyn Janae. Chambers. Baseline. Right hand floater. Bounces off the side of the iron. Does not go in. 53-34 at the break. 5 minutes to go. And this one. Penn trying to keep her foot on the gas. We come back. The fourth quarter here from the Palestra. And the head looks to continue. Top of the Ivy League. Michelle Lucchetti working her way off the glass. Comes on top. You're watching. That was the basketball here.
This game brought to you by Academy Bus, Alcom Printing Group, PNC Bank, and Wahoo's Tacos and More.
Looking out for each other here at the Palestra. Sorry about that, folks. We had a little problem with the mic. Back underway as Babo gives the ball up. Lekowitz. Jordan just poised at that baseline of the knee. 15 on the shot clock. Jordan trying to go against Stepanovic. Not getting much room. Stepanovic to block.
Yeah, she turned around. She immediately tossed Stepanovic there. Kind of froze, didn't know what to do.
And Stepanovic exactly did not move the feet, did not budge an inch. A tip there by Zabo in the steal, so Dartmouth now coming back the other way. And no shot. A foul's going to be called against Chambers. That is the call. That's her first. First for the fourth quarter. Head coach Mike McLaughlin not happy with it. Bernadette Lukaitis to his right. Long pass inbound. Norman now trying inside the lane. Smith. She kicks back outside. Jordan once again. Lekowitz. Jordan will now have some room in the lane. Anna Ross causes the fit. Comes over to get a hand up, but too late is Andy Norman. Knocks down a triple, her seventh point of the evening. 53-39 is the score here in the fourth. Stepanovic. Whitlatch up top, Lucchetti in the left wing. Chambers. Now Stepanovic. Trying to go inside, but too short. Right to the awaiting hands of Andy Norman, so Dartmouth gets lucky there as they come back up the floor.
Yeah, that was definitely some miscommunication by Locati and Ross. Ross thought she was coming over all the way and just wasn't quite there.
Now we'll see if Dartmouth can capitalize on it as Olivia Smith goes in right hand off the iron. Doesn't go. Michelle Locati, another rebound. Casey Chambers to Anna Ross. Ross loses it for a brief moment, and now Stepanovic. Stepanovic, nobody home there. Anna Ross going right. Stip went left. And the ball wound up in the first row. Dartmouth, once again, an opportunity to capitalize and start chipping away at this deficit. Szabo against Chambers across the foot D here at the Palestra. Szabo goes right. Now to Norman on the left elbow. Jordan. Likewise. Likewise. No foul. Walk called. But she steps out of bounds, so it'll be 10 ball. So, a no call from the official and Coach Mike McLaughlin.
Definitely a close one. I mean, no harm done. Stepped out of bounds. It's okay.
So, Casey Chambers. Now a little confusion as far as the offense. So 14 seconds left. Now the move to the left side. Locati. Locati trying baseline. Kicks to the right side. It gets tipped and goes out of bounds. 10 ball, but with only 8 seconds left in the shot clock. As Amber Mixon comes back in, replacing Patty Szabo. Szabo going to the bench. Sitting on 5 points in the steal. And with 8 seconds on the shot clock. Anna Ross. To Chambers with five. Stepanovic for three on the right wing. Off the iron. Anna Ross gets a handle to it. Gets the put back. It gets fouled on the way up. So great work there by the sophomore. As Daisy Jordan gets called for her second of the evening. Anna Ross for two. Taking a look at it once again. Anna Ross just comes flying in with the left hand. Gets to it. Fouled on the way. Anna Ross goes for her second offering. Gets it to go. Andy Norman comes off.
See if Blake and Rowan can start going again.
Only 4 points on the evening, as we said. 40% normally from the field. Having a bother with it tonight.
Yeah, and foul trouble has really hurt her. She's definitely one that the longer that she's out there, the better she's going to play.
Back goes off the foot of Stepanovic, so it'll be Dartmouth ball. 15 on the shot clock, 7 minutes left to go here in tonight's contest. Long inbound pass to Amber Mixon. Now to Rowland. Rowland trying to move right hand off the glass, no good. But a foul is called underneath. And it's going to be against Olivia Smith. Second team foul. So Penn will work their way up the floor one more time. Casey Chambers with Michelle Locati. Amber Mixon in tow. Now the pass to the left side. Anna Ross, the right wing for three, and it's light. Smith right there for the rebound. Here comes Mixon. Smith backpedals and gives to Rowland. With 17 on the shot clock, Mixon sets up another play up top. Mixon against Chambers towards the right elbow. Now to Rowland. Back to Mixon. Mixon rolling left, trying to go inside. Smith, nothing there. Jordan. Jordan drives behind Stepanovic, can't get it to roll. And Stepanovic will come away with the rebound, but a jump ball will be called. This time, it'll favor for the home side. So, good work by Stepanovic to get a handle to it.
Look for time to run a little clock now. Be aggressive, but still take their time and get the best shot that they possibly can.
Adam with the ball up top, down low. Chambers, two more points. And an assist for Sydney Stepanovic. A very pretty 2 points onto the board, making it 57-39 here in the fourth. Mixon, she'll pop for two, too strong. Jordan, the putback, she gets fouled on the way, she'll go to the line. Lauren Whitlatch, her second foul for the Quakers for the fourth. And Jordan will go to the line for two. 66% from the line. She's got a total of 10 points on the evening. Now making 11, she had a season high of 16 against Columbia. As Ashley Russell is set to come back in. And will replace Anna Ross. Ross comes to the bench. A pair of triples to her credit as well. And Daisy Jordan collects point number 12 for herself, 41 for her team. Daisy Chambers brings the ball across the line. Was heading. Stepanovic up top. Now Lauren Whitlatch. That was blocked as Rowland got a hand to it. Dartmouth the rebound. The big green coming up the floor. Amber Mixon. Smith will turn around and knock down. That's her sixth. 57-43 is the score. Just under 5 minutes left to go here in the fourth. Casey Chambers. Amber Mixon right there with her. Chambers going left. Stepanovic the left elbow. Long pass to Ashley Russell on the right side. Russell once again, but this time Lauren Whitlatch recovers. 6 seconds left. Rocchetti baseline with four. Rocchetti's going to go up and rattle one home.
Really
a little nerve-wracking there.
Interesting possession by Penn. It's one of those ones that coach like awful possession, but ball went in, so you can't get mad.
You said to work the clock a little bit. Not like that, though.
No, not quite.
59-43, just over 4 minutes left to go here in the fourth. Lekowitz, right side, Mixon. Smith now trying to go down low. Jordan just off the left box. He knocks down another bucket. Rowland with the assist. 59-45 is the score. 3-45 as Casey Chambers comes across the line. Chambers going left. Now Stepanovic top of the key. Wide left. And Lauren Whitlatch with the steal. The putback and two. Off of the steal, Lauren Whitlatch puts down her 14th point of the evening, giving Penn to that magical number 60. 61 points total. And Dartmouth will call time out. 61-45 left to go here in the fourth. And that brings us to a timeout on the floor. Michelle Wachetti taking every second she can off the shot clock for two more. Penn's on top, 61-45. You're watching Penn League basketball here on the Ivy League Digital Network.
Since 1740, Penn has upheld a long tradition of excellence through pathbreaking research and dedicated teaching in service of local and global communities. Penn creates knowledge and improves the world. It is because of your generosity that Penn is able to reach even greater heights. Thank you all for supporting the University of Pennsylvania.
Schedule for Penn Women's Basketball. basketball getting shorter and shorter. Tomorrow night, senior night, as the Crimson comes to call. And then it all ends at Jadwin Gymnasium, Tuesday, March the 8th, 5:30 start. A doubleheader for Penn and Princeton men and women's basketball, the tradition to end this season. Right now, Penn trying to keep the tradition of scoring more than 60 points and coming away with a victory. Dartmouth with the ball now up top, trying to go right side, off the hand of Roland. It's good for two more points.
Yeah, Dartmouth has just, the last few possessions, they've done really well just passing the ball. You know, it's tough when you're down by a lot, but.
And Anna Ross, a bit of a mental error, steps on the line right in front of the Penn bench.
Yeah, Dartmouth isn't going away.
No, they will not. That team that you know very well will not go away quietly.
No team in the Ivy League.
No,
none of them.
I mean, any
it's
team,
not in anybody's nature to give up here.
Any given night, again, you know, Penn had the loss up at Cornell. And give credit to Cornell. They just hit everything. So, always exciting basketball here within the Ivy League. As Dartmouth now with the ball. Anna Ross trying to steal with it. But now Roland goes back door, up and underneath. 2 points off of Keely Brown coming in off the bench. Brown, the 5'8 freshman from Henderson, Nevada, knocks down her 29th point of the year. Whitlatch up top. Goes back to Anna Ross. Ross. Whitlatch once again. Wachetti with 10. Wachetti's going to think about it. Go left hand off the glass. And brings home two more points. Michelle Wachetti gets 17 on the night. 63-49 to score. 2 minutes left to go here in this one as Wachetti tried to reach in, but will get called for the foul. That's her second, third team foul this quarter. And Dartmouth will once again call timeout. We'll stay here. 63-49 is the score. And as we get set and squared away for tomorrow night as well, we'll be honoring our seniors. Working today, Sierra Ray, and we say it all the time. I did the same thing last year with you guys. 4 years just goes by very quickly, especially with you in the Ivy League. ILDA this week as well. Tomorrow night, men's lacrosse, women's lacrosse, a doubleheader. The men will take on Penn State at noon. The women will start their Ivy League push against Brown at 3. And then we'll be back here at 7 o'clock. All of these games here on the Ivy League Digital Network. The Penn Band as well, keeping things going. And you said Michelle Wachetti knocking down 17 points. A little bit of a scoring drought, if you will. It's her first double-double for Wachetti since back on the 21st of January. So Michelle getting back into her rhythm and at a more proper time as we push towards the end of the regular season. Right now in the ballgame, Sky Leopold for Dartmouth, as well as Emily Slagle. Gionis into the ballgame as well. Underneath, Dryden. Gionis with the rebound against Stepanovic, the left hand, can't get it to go. Stepanovic will take the board.
And with that rebound, Stepanovic has a double-double, which may be the first time this year that Wachetti and Stepanovic have had double-doubles. No?
No, I think they pulled them off a couple times.
I thought they have had a lot of double-doubles this year, but always in different games. And, oh, Stepanovic, nice move underneath.
The Dartmouth with the ball. Sky Leopold goes to the rack and emphatically gets blocked by Michelle Wachetti. Michelle Wachetti, 6'3", Sky Leopold, 5'2". Taking a look at it again. Give credit for Leopold. Going to try the baseline. She goes up, and Michelle Wachetti bids her welcome to the Palestra. Swatting that one away. Penn making wholesale substitutions. Now on the floor, Kristen Daly, Brooklyn Janae, Jackie Falconer, Daisy Jackson joining Ashley Russell, the starters getting put to the bench for the evening. A great work by the starting lineup for the red and blue. Brooklyn Janae, we'll talk more about her tomorrow night. Gives to Dejan Jackson. Jackson, baseline. In traffic, gets to Falcon. Falcon, it goes right hand. Gets the foul and the finish all the way. Jackie Falconer with a nice slide to the basket. Knocks down her 23rd point of the year. Dejan Jackson finds Falconer going to the rack. Gets it off the glass. Cannot get it to finish. Dartmouth, though, with the ball. Falconer, the first non-starter points of the contest, coming late in the fourth, so giving the keys to the starters tonight as Dartmouth just trying to get two more to the board as the shot goes up. Giannis couldn't get it to fall. She had 2 points on the year to score against Maine. Falconer gets called for the foul. So Penn on its way to tying a program record for most wins in a game with 22-4 on the year. So the winning ways continuing for the red and blue as Giannis' shot does not go through. Dartmouth will fall to 12-17 overall, 7-6. In the ancient eight. And Brooklyn Janae will inbound to Deja Jackson. The final 5 seconds will come off. Penn gets the first game of the final weekend here at the Palestra. 65-50. The red and blue taking care of business as the coaches congratulate each other. Handshakes continuing in front of us. So again, tomorrow night, a full day of activity here. The Ivy League Digital Network will cross the double header. The men's game you can see up at Harvard. The Crimson women will be here. And we will honor our seniors for 4 years of Penn women's basketball. Penn comes away once again, tying the program record for most wins in a season with 22. As we get set for some post-game reaction, Corbin Carnegie getting the coach, and we'll have a couple players as well. But Katie, definitely a few tense moments for the red and blue coming down the home stretch. And ultimately, as you said, the shot may not have looked good, but the ball went in. Then coming away with the win tonight. Going to have to reload and regroup for tomorrow for the Crimson. But just like Dartmouth, now the team take their eyes off it.
Yeah, and they're a different style of play than Dartmouth. Dartmouth is, you know, get those offensive rebounds, tough team, battles defensively, and Harvard's just going to want to score, see if Tech can keep them in check or if it's going to be a game that's in the 70s.
Not so much a look to the scoreboard, but we did notice that Princeton was starting to pull away. But taking a look at some of the numbers here, we talked about the work in the paint. Penn narrowly out-rebounding Dartmouth, 34-30 overall. The big storyline on the stats tonight, Penn 8 of 16 from outside. Dartmouth did not get the three ball going. 4 of 14. They were 21 of 56 from the field. Both teams are doing battle in the paint. Penn 26, Dartmouth 28. But Penn 16 points off of turnovers as we get set to bring in Corbin Carnegie. Corbin is set up now with Coach McLaughlin and Michelle Manning. Corbin.
It was another double-double for you tonight. What was your strategy going into
tonight. Thanks a lot, Corbin, and as the coach and Michelle says, Katie, hoping for same excitement, same reaction, and hopefully same result as Penn will look to get its 23rd win of the year. That's going to wrap things up for us here, the Ivy League Digital Network. One more time, your final score of 65-50 here at the Palestra. Make sure you come back here tomorrow for all of these slate of games we have, but also for Penn women's basketball, the final home game against Dartmouth. Setting down Michelle McKenney, the looks off the glass, and taking care of business. We'll see what they can do tomorrow night. Thanks for watching. This has been a presentation of the Ivy League Digital Network.